We opened up, starting in 1986, of course, but we couldn't do all the things we wanted to do to reform our socio-political economy. And therefore, our entry into APEC was a very good time to begin reforming and transforming. For instance, we increased our connectivities and foreign relations all over the world. As you and I know, and all of the APEC member countries know this, including those outside APEC, mankind in the 21st century is no longer faced with grave threats from other countries nearby or far away, within the region or outside the Asia-Pacific region. But our common enemies now, and the countries of APEC are especially vulnerable, especially the Philippines, to these modern-day threats. And these are climate change because of global warming. And this is due to the abuse by people around the world of the environment. Secondly, there's also the massive incidence of poverty around the world. And this has required people's defenses against deprivation and hopefully people's benefits in terms of decent housing, good basic education for the little kids, and of course health care and longevity for Earth's people. The world is not yet fully recovered from the recession of 2008, which started in the US and very quickly spread to Europe and also to Asia in a certain degree. But it is the US and Europe, or the Western democracies, that suffered the most from the economic recession that started in 2008. Now, I think the APEC countries, 21 of us, and maybe some more might be coming in, both developed and developing, both advanced and emerging, must start thinking of putting up a cooperative reserve fund to protect us from economic recession of whatever kind. It is the economic benefit that people are really looking at. It's not so much the political connection or the defense alliance, but in the end, it's 3 meals a day, it's a better home, it's insurance for the kids so that they can finish college, and the ability to travel, learn about other people after retirement. So you must have that little nest ego. I think this is the ambition of every family, regardless of nationality around the world. And here again, APEC is in the lead. As we have always said in the Philippines and also in APEC, there must be a democratic distribution of wealth and benefits. It's okay to have plenty of wealth, but it's not okay to have so many poor people. So the solution is obviously redistribute the wealth according to your efforts put into the enterprise. And in the Philippines, we have a very candid model for portraying this idea. And we say, we must grow the economy so that there is fire from the bottom and there is fire from the top. Just like the way we cook the very delicious Filipino rice cake called bibingka. Fire from the bottom is the effort of the poor people at the grassroots through their industry, energy, and even talent. And fire from the top means the national leadership must provide connections with the global market, transfer of technology, and then distribute the national assets so that this also go down. Not trickle down, but really go down to the grassroots so that they can expand. And I think all countries have to do this.